time I used this camera, we were in Florida. Situated in central Florida, Cypress Gardens was the creation of Dick and Julie Pope and opened to the public on the 1st of January 1936. Apparently, Julie was a Southern belle from Alabama, and when a storm devastated the flowers one winter, she decided to dress up her girls to attract people's attention, and so the photo opportunity was born. To get your bearings round here, it's best to head for the island in the sky.
Brought to this location, erected here in 1983, at a cost of $2.6 million. It's one of three in the world today, this one in Japan, one in Holland. This is the original. It's hydraulically operated, computer controlled. The carousel on which you're riding weighs 12.5 tons. It was engineered and designed to carry up to 100 adults at full capacity. It's attached to a 150-foot arm. On the other end of the long lifting arm is a counterweight made of reinforced concrete. Weighs 370 tons.
The twice daily ski show has just started on Lake Eloise.
Voted by his peers last year as our skier of the year. Ryan Welch. Corbin, this is Ski Extreme. Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Ryan from Winter Haven. Sherry out of Burlington, Wisconsin. And Frank from Tampa. The best of the Noshu and Uncles, our husband and wife team. We proudly fly the red, white, and blue.
Happy pulling the birds. Fortunately, they are small and feathered, and it only cost him a dollar. I've just heard they've got some delicious key lime pie down at the gazebo. About 200 couples a year are attracted to these romantic gardens to take their marriage vows, and for a nice wedding present, perhaps, a realistic wildlife sculpture. Oh, some are just a bit too realistic. It's quite restful to cruise the botanical gardens, which were carved out of an alligator and snake-infested cypress swamp. But beware, some of the alligators still live here.
Those little spiky things hanging out of the water there, those are called knees, and that is how the tree breathes.
Thank you. You can get a lot of close encounters when you stroll along these pathways. Because this is an alligator in front of me. I should move pretty damn quick, I'll tell you. He's had his eyes, I think. He's got his eye on me. Like these animals, I don't scare that easy, but I'm not too sure about touching some of the creatures in Nature's Arena show.
You're the fun of wearing a microphone there, Kevin. Hello. And hey, wonder what type of prey he goes after? Very simple. By looking at his body structure, you can tell that he goes after other birds. They can see approximately 100 times better than we can in dim light.
You might see his tongue. It looks just like a person's tongue. He'll bite through the squash with his beak. He'll pull the squash inside his mouth. And you might even see that squash as it goes right down his throat.
And a long neck, a long body, and a long tail. He even has a long forked tongue like a snake. And if he touches you with his tongue, nothing happens. Many animals eat them when they're young. When he hatched, he was only 8 inches long. He only weighed about an ounce and a half. When he's fully grown, he'll at least be as big as his mother. 8 feet long, weighing 200 pounds. The males grow bigger, sometimes reaching 12 feet and over 400 pounds. Quite a few 13-foot alligators have been found here in Florida in recent years. He was born with the camouflage pattern. He's born without the dark chemical pigments that would have provided his camouflage color. In the wild, it would have been difficult for him to survive. When he hatched, he used to coil up in the palm of my hand. Many animals hunt these giant snakes when they're small. As far as we know, no animals hunt them when they grow this big. He was left with one chemical pigment, so he doesn't have sensitive skin or sensitive eyes like other albinos might have. And you can appreciate why we have named him Banana Boy. He's 7 years old now. He's grown a lot in 7 years. He crawls in a straight line. He's 14 and a half feet long now. He weighs 120 pounds.
That's cheap.
Okay, what color is it? Looks sort of like a robin.
It's been a great day, but to the people who work here, I suppose it's just another day in the garden.
Make plans to come back and see us again real soon, folks, and we'll be here waiting for you at Florida's original showplace, beautiful Cypress Gardens. Thank you again and have a great afternoon.